Hello everyone, in this video I want to show you how to set up port forwarding so that you can access from the internet services running on your main router when your main router has a private WAN IP. So let me now explain the setup that you see in front of you and that I'm gonna use to establish port forwarding from this router to this router. So this here is a root router. So this is a router that has a public WAN IP that is accessible from the internet. And this here is an internal router that has a VPN server, and this internal router has a private WAN IP that it took from the root router. Now, I have a client that is connected to the internet, and this client wants to access a VPN server on the internal router. So I'm going to establish port forwarding from this root router to this internal router so that this client, when it wants to access a VPN server that is running on this internal router, will access it through this router, through port forwarding. So let me switch to screen recording to show you all this. So on the screen in front of you here, you see the internal router that has a VPN server, and this internal router has a private WAN IP. The first thing you need to do is to get the WAN IP of this router that is a private WAN IP. So here I have Asus routers, but the instructions I'm gonna show you will also apply to other routers. You just have to match the instructions I'm showing you on my Asus router. So here, click on network map to get the private WAN IP of this router. So this is a private WAN IP. It is 192.168.69.202. So you need to note this IP somewhere because we're gonna use it later on. And here also, I'm going to show you the VPN server, how it is configured. So here under VPN, it is an OpenVPN server. So this is my OpenVPN server. You need also to get the server port of the server. So you have the private WAN IP that we got, and you have the server port. And also here you have the user and the password of the user that is allowed to use a VPN server. So these are the only three things you need from your internal router. So now let's go to the root router that has a public WAN IP. On it, I'm gonna configure port forwarding. So this is the root router. Of course, also you need to get its WAN IP. So this is a public WAN IP. Also take a note of this IP. Now I'm gonna show you an optional step, but I highly recommend it so that the IP of the internal router will not change. So we're gonna assign it manually on this root router. So here, go to LAN and then go to DHCP server, and under DHCP server, scroll to the bottom, and here you have manually assigned IP around the DHCP list. So here you need to add the IP of the internal router so that this IP will not change. So here, click on the list and choose the router, and this is the IP of the router. So these two fields are optional. So click on the plus sign here and then click on apply. So now the private WAN IP of the internal router will never change and it will stay the same. And this is easier for the future so that you don't have to always change the port forwarding configuration. And here on the root router, now we need to configure port forwarding. So click on WAN. And then under WAN, choose virtual server port forwarding. And here you need to toggle it to on. And here you need to add the profile of the OpenVPN server on the internal router. So click on add profile. And the server list here, select OpenVPN. And under service name, keep it as it is. Under protocol, keep it UDP. The external port, it is 1194, keep it as it is. And the internal port, and this is where the internal port that we took from the internal router, we need to put it. So it is 1024. And the internal IP address here, it is the internal IP address of the internal router. So it is 69202 here. You need to change it and keep source IP empty and then click on OK. And here's the port forwarding established. And this is all you need to do on the root router. Now, there's an optional step also that you can do on the root router that will make your life easier also, is to give it a DDNS name. So this way you don't have to change the IP that is on the configuration file that I'm gonna show you in a bit each time your ISP changes your WAN IP. So I've done many videos on how to assign a DDNS entry to your router. If you want to check out these videos, I'm going to leave a link in the description, and this way you can assign a DNS entry to your root router. So now let's go back to the internal router, and here we need to export the client OpenVPN file, and we need to change it, and I'm going to show you how to change it. So go to VPN once again, and let's click on OpenVPN, and here click on export to export the file, and let's save it. So let me show you the file here under the downloads folder. So I'm going to open it with Notepad. So right click on it and then click on open with, choose Notepad, and then click on just once. So you see the IP address here. It took the IP address of the internal router, and it took also the port of the internal router. And you need to change both so that they will match the IP and the port of the external router, so the root router. So here you need to put the WAN IP, and this is where you can also put the DNS name if you don't want to use the WAN IP. So this is the WAN IP, and now we need to put the port, that is 1194, and this is the port of the port forwarding when we established it. So now you need to save the file, and then you need to share this file with the clients that will access your VPN server. So let me save the file, and let's put it on a USB drive and switch to the client to show you how it will work. So this is a laptop that is connected to the internet and that I'm gonna use to connect to my VPN server on my internal router. So this is OpenVPN client, and this is the client configuration file that we copied from the USB key to this laptop. So let me drag it here. So this is the WAN IP, and now I need to put the name of the VPN client. So it is KSTech user, like this. And then I'm gonna click on connect. And here I need to put the password for this user. And now it will connect to the VPN server, and I'm gonna show you how it is connected. So let's click on OK. And you see now that we are connected to the VPN server that is running on the router that has a private WAN IP. So let me show you now the client, how it is connected. So this is an internal router with a private WAN IP, and you see that KSTech user, it is connected. So now to demonstrate to you how you can access resources on your internal network from a client that is connected through port forwarding to your internal router, I'm gonna go to the administration page of the internal router from the internet client. So let me open Edge here. So let's go to the IP of the internal router here, and you're gonna see that I can access its administration page. And you see this is administration page of the router. So if I disconnect the VPN client, I shouldn't be able to access this administration page. Let me disconnect it. So now it is disconnected. Let's refresh this page. And you see that I can no longer access the administration page, even if I try to access it once again using the IP address, because I am disconnected from the VPN, and thus I am disconnected from my internal network. If you have any questions or comments, don't hesitate to put them in the comments section below, and I'll be happy to answer all your questions and all your comments. I hope that you liked this video and you found it useful. In case you did, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. I want to thank you all for watching. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. See you in the next video.